I strive to support a state of balance through the year by making a conscious effort to adjust my activities and the way I nourish my body according to the cycles of nature. Each season has a distinct personality, and I love all of them. I truly do. But summer has always been my favorite season. Maybe that is why I was always drawn to the magic of land with tropical climates, and as a result, I ended up settling in Florida. Even though at first glance it seems like I live in perpetual summer, it is not so. The summer season has its distinct, ever-expanding character of transformative nature. The abundance of light, all-consuming intensity, passionate fire, and scorching heat contrasted by sheer energy of unruly tropical storms and the soft, benevolent body of an ocean. That's what summer is to me. The adjustments in lifestyle and eating patterns come naturally to me. As summer rolls, a few simple changes dramatically increase my vitality and support my health. I naturally tend to seek coolness during hot summer days, balancing intensity with relaxation and grounding energy. I tend to gravitate more to quiet and restful activities. During summer, my body naturally craves light foods and smaller meals. I lean more towards food that is more hydrating to my body, like fresh raw fruits. Taking my time during the meal, eating consciously, savoring my food makes me satisfied and well nourished. During the day, often I treat myself to the most delicious homemade ice cream. For that, I keep plenty of freshly frozen fruit in the fridge. Some of my favorite places to go on a weekend during this time are farmers markets and fruit stands. I always get so excited. I feel so blessed living in a tropical land that showers you with an abundance of all kind of delicious and juicy goodness. Local markets during fruit season are always an adventure to me, a treasure hunt, a joyride, an exploration mission. I never know what awaits and what kind of gifts Mother Nature has in store for me. I get the most excited when I come across something that I never tried before. If you're following me on Instagram or Facebook, you see me sharing some of the amazing fruit hunts I had.
Breakfast.
The summer way of eating to me is mostly all about seasonal fruits, so fresh smoothies and fruit salads are in abundance daily. Among all exotic fruit varieties I'm fortunate to indulge myself with, I have plenty of readily accessible fruits like mangoes, avocados, coconuts and coconut water, melons, plums, peaches, apples and pears, and every kind of berry that comes my way. In the way of beverages, during the heat of the day, I enjoy room temperature water infused with mint or lemon, cooling ash gourd or cucumber juice, cooling herbal teas like peppermint, licorice, fennel or rose. As to the vegetables, I enjoy plenty of ash gourd, cucumbers, zucchini, green beans, celery, cauliflower, cabbage, and Brussels sprouts. Sometimes I do beets with beet greens and variety of sweet potatoes. For greens, I favor oats, barley, and quinoa. When it comes to legumes and beans, I tend to eat much less of them compared to other times of the year. During the summer months, I prefer mung beans, peas, cranberry beans, adzuki beans, chickpeas and chana dal, white beans like cannellini, red lentils, or pinto beans. When I cook the beans, I love them to be very well done, you know, more on the overcooked side. I feel it easier on my digestion this way. When it comes to nuts, blanched almonds are the most conducive to the summer months because of their cooling properties. For the oil, I tend to use coconut oil or ghee for cooking and virgin oil or grapeseed oil for salads.
Oh my God, look at this!
I love to experience this burst of life that happens around me during this time of the year. Everything around is so alive and vibrant, thriving and expanding. Did I mention that everything sprouts in my kitchen? Just leave it on my counter for 3 days and watch it grow. The other day, I went into the farmer's market and I spotted some fresh cranberry pods. They made me so happy. What made me even happier is when I opened the pods, I noticed that some of the beans are at the beginning of the sprouting process.
Look at this, they sprouted. That's sprouted beans. They're alive. How cool.
I got so excited, so I decided to set them aside for a day or two so they sprout more before I cook them. I guess when you observe a sprouting process, there is a cute awareness of unfolding miracle of life. And I just can't help myself but be overtaken by the grace. and an overwhelming feeling of the gratitude to the life that is willing to become me. Now let's make some salad. So this time I got lucky with sprouting fresh beans, but usually I use dry variety. I always start with soaking dry beans overnight with a pinch of salt and a splash of lemon. In the morning, rinse them thoroughly and set aside in a mesh sieve covered with a cotton cloth. When you're ready, transfer beans into a pot with 2 cups of water. Bring them to a boil, lower the heat and continue cooking on a gentle boil. In a half an hour, add 1 teaspoon of Himalayan salt and universal sattvic spice mix. If you did not make it yet, you can see the way I make it in this video. Can you go without universal sattvic spice mix? Yes, you can. Would it be the same? No, not really, but it still will be good. I highly recommend this spice mix though. If you do use the universal sattvic spice mix, the juice, the bean juice, comes out so delicious. It would be shame not to use it. Strain the beans through a mesh sieve and set them aside to cool. The remaining liquid, called aquafaba, can be poured to the ice cube containers and then frozen for future use in soups, curries, stews or other dishes. That's what I do most often. But if you're not inclined on freezing it, you can use it right away as a base for your rice or quinoa, and then serve it on a side with your salad. Next, I want to talk a little bit about corn. When it comes to corn, I prefer fresh over frozen. Fresh corn on the cob, you know, with a husk and corn silks, all the good stuff. Now, if fresh corn is not available, then I would go with the frozen variety, but definitely not the canned one. If going with the frozen one, you will need 2 cups of it. Cook it in a pan under the lid with a pinch of salt for about 5 minutes. If you're going with the fresh corn, then lavish yourself in the process. I love everything about the process. The sound of a breaking husk, the smell of a corn silks. Oh my, it brings me right back into my childhood. I can see my grandma's calloused hands going through the pile of corn and a little me sitting at her feet playing with the corn dolls, braiding the silky cob tops in the fancy hairstyles and playing with them like they were the most fancy dolls in the world. The long and shiny fibers on the top of the cob called corn silks. I dry corn silk and store it in the airtight jar. I'm making brew out of them from time to time. I use it as medicine. Traditionally, corn silk used for blood infections, inflammation of the urinary system, inflammation of the prostate, and kidney stones. It is also used to treat diabetes, high blood pressure, fatigue, and high cholesterol levels. So after cups are stripped and cleaned, they are ready to be cooked. Fill large pot about 3/4 full of water and bring it to a boil. Then gently transfer corn into a pot. Cover the pot with a lid and bring it back to a boil. Let it cook for about 20 minutes on a gentle roll. Then remove corn and the cob from the hot water and place it on the platter to cool a bit. To remove the corn from the cob, place one end of the cob on the cutting board. Then cut downwards with the knife as close to the base of the kernels as possible, while taking care not to angle the blade into the cob itself. And here's the tip. Run the back of a knife along with the cob to extract the rest of the corns and extra corn milk. This will add a lot of extra flavor to the dish. And then chop away. Peel and chop mangoes into small cubes. Then do the same with avocados. Place avocados in a separate bowl and add a pinch of salt and a lemon juice and mix well. After you chop the parsley into fine pieces, then you are ready to combine all the ingredients in a large bowl. Mix well and sprinkle on the top with a freshly ground coconut if you have it. This salad is so juicy and flavorful that I feel that no dressing is needed. You can add a couple more spoons of lemon juice if needed. I feel like avocado adds enough creaminess and mango bathes it with its juiciness. The perfect combination between sweet and sour, tangy and salty. You can enjoy it as this or serve it with a side of rice, quinoa or buckwheat. If you want more information and all the digital instructions and everything I was talking about here plus more, you can find it on positivesprouting.com website. Please drop me a line or two. I really enjoy reading your comments. It means a lot to me. And well, at least hit the like button so I know that you like the video. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.